Hello, my dear friends. I hope you are all doing well. I'm just standing in front of a big area of mentally retarded people. It is in Wiesloch. There are thousands of people who are living in this complex. From the slightly retarded people, children, young people and old people, till the people who have become criminals because they could not adjust with others and they have done harm to people, so they are also arrested here. It is called PZN. Maybe you can see in the internet about this big hospital. In a way, I would say these people are living in darkness. Many people take so much medicine that they just walk like vegetables. That means they are not living in the reality. They are given so much medicaments that they cannot live in themselves. Just now I have visited a boy. He is only 18 years old and he is having a lot of fear in his life. So he is kept in a closed house that he cannot come out because he thinks that somebody will come and kill him. It's a very horrible situation. In a way, for him and for the patients here, it is only darkness. The life is only darkness. Paul is writing in this weekend in all the Catholic masses that we are not people of darkness. We are people of light. Of course, we all love to be in light. For example, in this wonderful morning, I'm just standing in front of the sun. And I'm so happy to have light, to see light. Especially in Germany, there are some days where you don't see any sun at all. That means we Germans are very delighted to see light. If I have light, then it is warm and it is not that cold. That means I am having very good time now. So the whole life is actually a process where we can have light, or we are searching for light. But the experience tells us that we don't have always light. There is always darkness also. That means we are always challenged how we go along with this darkness and light. We cannot just sit only in light. We cannot also sit only in darkness. But the religion, especially the Christian religion, gives hope that we are called for light. That is why Jesus says, "You are the light of the world." That means we have to have light in us. Only if we have light in us, then we are happy, and we are happy to be with other people, and we can adjust with the situations, whatever it may come, and we give this gift to others, that others also can become happy, can have light. The whole life is a challenge in a sense that we should live in light as the day and night come. So happiness and sorrow, sadness also come. But it is in us, dear brothers and sisters, to make darkness to light. And there Jesus says that we are not alone. We can have light in us. In a sense, every day we say to ourselves, God is with us, God is with me. I just told this boy as I visited him, "Dear friend, think that God is with you." Then he told me, "Father, please pray with me." Then I prayed with him. After my visit, as I came out, he was telling his nurses, "I'm so happy that Father has come to me." That means I could give little light to him. So let us try in this week to give little light to others, especially the people who really are sitting in darkness, like these patients in this hospital. So my dear friends, let us have a wonderful week with God's light, and let us bring light to others. Take care. Bye-bye.